Assalamu alaikum dear friends, I am Sajid Ali. In my last lecture we discussed Delhi Muslim proposals. So that lecture was without the board. So dear friends, in this lecture we discuss Simon Commission. Simon Commission, it was a commission appointed by British government in India to bring reforms, constitutional reforms. So dear friends, it was appointed in 1927. According to Chelmsford reforms, which was introduced in 1919, Chelmsford reforms was also the constitutional reforms in India. These constitutional reforms were introduced by British government in India. So according to Chelmsford reforms, its section 84A section of Chelmsford reforms, a commission would be appointed after 10 years by British government in India to bring reforms, constitutional reforms. So dear friends, when British government decided to appoint a commission to bring, to make constitutional reforms, so it should make a commission, it should appoint a commission after 10 years. When they decided to appoint a commission, it was the year 1927. So that's why it was the premature commission of British government. Why they appointed prematurely? Why they appointed the Simon Commission 2 years before, in 1927, but the government in India, British government in India, had to appoint a commission to bring constitutional reforms in 1929. But it appointed the commission in 1927. That's why they appointed the Simon Commission 2 years ago. So dear friends, what were reasons behind it? Why they appointed commission 2 years before? So we are going to discuss. At first, these are members of commission. Sir John Simon, he was chairman of the commission. And all other six are members under the leadership of Sir John Simon. Because of his name, this commission was also given the name Simon Commission, because of Sir John Simon. He was the chairman of this commission. And a Viscount Burnham, Baron Strathcona, Edward Cotgun, Veron Hartshorn, Richard Lane Fox, Clement Attlee, these all are members of the commission. But this, Sir John Simon was the chairman, including the member of this commission. They had to bring some reforms, constitutional reforms. They had to make a report of the Indian constitutional reforms development. So dear friends, these all are members of the commission. There were total 7 members in Simon Commission. What were the causes behind the appointment of commission, and why it was appointed before in 1927? As I already told you, It was appointed in 1927, but British government in India had to appoint it 1929. So, dear friends, when commission was appointed in British, in Great Britain, there was the government of Conservative Party. So, it feared of the propaganda of Labour Party for the problems of India, and it feared for the loss of next election in 1927 election. That's why Conservative Party appointed Simon Commission 2 years before. And the second cause was also that Indian leaders also criticized over the British government in India. So, dear friends, these are the causes of appointment of the commission. Reaction of the Indians. When the Simon Commission was appointed, what were the reaction of Indians? Whether Muslims, Hindus, Buddhists or Sikh communities and other political parties, what were their reactions and reply? So, dear friends, almost all Indians were against the Simon Commission, because there was no any Indian in Simon Commission. All these members were British, Englishmen. They were not Indian. That's why a majority of political parties and majority of peoples were not in favor of the commission. So, dear friends, Qaid Azam, what were the views of the Qaid Azam regarding the Simon Commission? Qaid Azam told Viceroy, he wrote a letter to Viceroy that you should change the name of commission from Simon Commission to Indian Commission. And he also suggested the Viceroy that you should appoint another commission and name it a joint commission. These proposals were introduced and given by Qaid Azam to the Viceroy. At first he told him, he wrote a letter and said him that to change the name of Simon Commission from Simon Commission to Indian Commission, or make another commission, joint commission, in which Indian members should be also appointed, nominated. So, dear friends, Muslim League and Congress, both political parties rejected Simon Commission and they boycotted it. Supportive parties, some political parties also supported. They were also in favor of Simon Commission, in which National Unionist Party, Central Mohammedan Association of Calcutta Party, it was made by Sayyid Amir Ali. European Association, it was also a political party. These all political parties supported the Simon Commission, its appointment. Justice Party. And dear friends, I want to also share something next, that Muslim League was also divided into two groups, two sections, Jannah League and Shafi League. As I discussed with you in my last lecture, the lecture of Delhi Muslim Proposals, in Delhi Muslim Proposals, Muslim League was divided into two groups, Jannah League and Shafi League. those members of Muslim League who favored withdraw of separate electorate, they supported Qaid-e-Azam, and those members who did not support the withdraw of separate electorate in Delhi Muslim proposals, they supported Shafi, Mian Muhammad Shafi, who was the leader of Provincial Muslim League in Punjab. So dear friends, here at the time of Simon Commission, Jinnah League supported, Jinnah League did not support Simon Commission, and Jinnah League boycott to the Simon Commission, but Shafi League supported the Simon Commission, including Allama Iqbal. So dear friends, all these political parties supported Simon Commission, its appointment, but Muslim League, Congress Muslim League, the group of Jinnah Muslim League, not Shafi Muslim League, boycott to the Simon Commission and its appointment, because no any Indians in Simon Commission, that's why. But according to the British government in India, they said that if we nominate 2 or 3 Indians for the commission, so it would create problems, and they could not solve the constitutional problems, they could not introduce reforms. In reply, such a statement of Secretary of State for India, Nehru, Motilal Nehru, decided to make a committee. In that committee, all political parties were invited to make a report in reply to Simon Commission, and that report was also the Nehru report. We will discuss inshallah in my next lecture. So this is also the part of this topic. And dear friends, visits of commission, how many times commission, the members of commission visited to India to make report and to see, to experience the problems, constitutional, political, economic and other problems. They visited at first 3rd February to 31st March 1928. They made half report, and second time they visited from 11th October 1928 to 13 April 1929. So dear friends, they completed their reports, and when they introduced, published their reports, there were two volumes in their report. In first volume, they discussed the problems of constitutional problems, political, economic, religious and other problems of India, they discussed in the first volume of report. And in second volume, they just discussed the constitutional reforms. So dear friends, in this way, they published the report. The main characteristics, main features of the Simon Commission's are as under diarchy system. Diarchy system was introduced at center according to the Simon Commission, but not in provinces. So dear friends, according to the Chelmsford reforms, which were introduced in 1919, according to that reforms, diarchy system was in provinces, but in Simon Commission it was cancelled and a diarchy system was introduced at center but cancelled at provinces. So dear friends, what was diarchy system? It was the dual system, dual government system. Some departments were looked after, supervised by governor himself and its executive council, and remaining less important departments were supervised by other ministers. So dear friends, that is called diarchy system. It means dual system. According to Simon Commission, it was introduced at center but not in provinces. Federal system was also introduced according to the Simon Commission. In federal system, center should be strong and some powers would be given to the provinces. To some extent, provinces would have to given autonomy. So dear friends, federal system was also introduced in Simon Commission. Separation of Sindh from Bombay. It was also said in Simon Commission that Sindh would be separated from Bombay Presidency. So dear friends, this is the main features and most important characteristics of Simon Commission report. This is the report of Simon Commission, final report, and it was published in 30 May 1930. So dear friends, in this way we discussed Simon Commission. These are members of Simon Commission, total 7 members, its causes, why it was introduced, it was appointed, and what was 84 section. It was the section of Montagu Chelmsford reforms, and it was introduced in 1927. Its final report was introduced and published in 30 May 1930. These political parties supported Simon Commission, but Qaid-e-Azam as well as Muslim League, Congress boycott to the Simon Commission. They were against to the Simon Commission. So dear friends, visits of the Commission. In this way we explain Simon Commission. In my next lecture we discuss Nehru Report and 14th points of Qaid-e-Azam. Dear friends, take care. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.